أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ قال ربك للملائكة إني جاعل في الأرض خليفة قالوا أتجعل فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء ونحن نسبح بحمدك ونقدس لك قال إني أعلم ما لا تعلمون وعلم آدم الأسماء كلها ثم عرضهم على الملائكة فقال أنبئوني بأسماء هؤلاء إن كنتم صادقين قالوا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم قال يا آدم أنبئهم بأسمائهم فلما أنبأهم بأسمائهم قال ألم أقل لكم إني أعلم غيب السماوات والأرض وأعلم ما تبدون وما كنتم تكتمون صدق الله وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, On number 19, Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayh told his son that when you are okay, you are in health and wealth. So at that time, you must be mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We violate and transgress the boundaries. When we are okay health-wise and wealth-wise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kalla, this is true. Innal insana layatgha. That human being violates and transgresses. Arra'ahu staghna. The moment he feels that he has become self-sufficient, he doesn't need anybody. He has billions. He has businesses. He has children. He is healthy. He has the status. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, these are things which makes a human a transgressor and violator. Kalla innal insana layatgha. Arra'ahu istaghna. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Zuyina linnasi hubbu shahwat. Min al-bani, min al-nisa'i wal-bani, wal-qanatir al-muqantara, wal-khayl al-musawwama, wal-dhahr wal-fizza. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, children, wife, gold, silver, cattle, horses, or nowadays we can say in America, ranches. These are the things which is considered a beauty of humanity, which is not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the moment someone has it, he violates and transgresses. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, nothing in this world is for free. You would be put to accountability for each and every single thing That's why Allah says, Inna ila rabbika ruj'a. Your final return is to Allah. Then He will ask you how you were when you heard all these things. And Ibn Abbas narrates, radiyallahu ta'ala an, the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, Ya Bunay, O my son, Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala an, احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. Be mindful of Allah 24/7. And that what we mean by zikrullah. Some people do explain zikrullah only to have a tasbih. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah. That's okay. But the actual zikrullah is to have Allah in your mind 24/7. When you will have Him in your mind, you will never violate any rule of Allah. You will be having a stop there on red light, not because of that this is traffic rules and laws here, but as you have signed the paper living in America to be a law-abiding citizen. So in dark night, when nobody is there, you are not violating that because you have the concept of Allah in your mind. That not the traffic police, Allah will ask me, a dark night, why you violated the rule? While you were under bond, you have signed. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, keep in mind my respected brothers and sisters, because I'm trying to give formulas to the brothers and sisters, kuliyat. So there is a kuliyat, and Quran and Sunnah, these are not laws. Once again, Quran and Sunnah are not laws. Once again, Quran and Sunnah are not laws. These two are the sources of law. So it gives you the formula. Then that is up to the jurist to deduce laws and rules therefrom, and they did it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith, Al-Muslimuna inda shurutihim. Now look, what a simple word. What a single sentence. What a concise wording of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Muslimuna inda shurutihim. Muslims are bound to stop with the conditions they agreed upon. Agreed upon with whom? With their Muslim brothers? With anybody? With a Muslim? With a non-Muslim? But to me, if you will violate something you agreed upon with a Muslim brother, that is also a sin. But not as bigger a sin as violating of an agreement with a non-Muslim. Why? The other party, the Muslim, he is Muslim, so he will say he did wrong. Yes, but when that is the case of a non-Muslim, directly he will go to your deen and to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's how the Muslims are. That's what Islam says. So by doing so, you are bringing a bad name to your deen, and that's an extra medicine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of you, so say Ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so anyhow, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ibn Abbas, be mindful of Allah, tajidhu tujahak. You will find Him standing in front of you. And he told him that, احفظ الله يحفظك. Be mindful of Allah, He will protect you for sure. Just look into the history of Sahaba. As I told you, that there are a few famous books in this regard. Sahaba were Muslims because of Muhammad, says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we are Muslims because of Sahaba. Yes. Sahaba were Muslims. Why? Because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why we are Muslims? We are because of Sahaba. We are thankful to Sahaba. Rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. And number two, this is not only a historical thing. This is a matter of love. So be in love with the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered us to have the same love for Sahaba. فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ. As you know, that I never miss this hadith in my khutbah. فَمَنْ أَحَبَّهُمْ فَبِحُبِّ أَحَبَّهُمْ. Be in love with my Sahaba, because you are in love with me. If I'm in love with you, so I will hate your kids. Say,
no.
No, I will be in love with your kids as well. فَبِحُبِّ أَحَبَّهُمْ And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, وَمَنَا قَضَهُمْ فَيُبُوزِيَ بْغَضَهُمْ Whosoever hated my Sahaba, he has not hated Sahaba, he hated me. فَمَنَا حَبَّهُمْ فَبِحُبِّ أَحَبَّهُمْ وَنَا مَغَضَهُمْ فَيُبُوزِيَ When you will be in love with Sahaba, you will never go to their mistakes. You will never mention it. Therefore, so Sayyidina Ali did this, oh, Sayyidina Muawiyah did this. Why you are saying it? Because you don't have love with Sahaba. When somebody is in love with Sahaba, yes, you have love for your wife, so she is doing lot of mistakes, but you are doing more than them. But anyhow, neither you nor she, maybe you, not she, yes, you are not looking at the mistakes because of the love you have. So when you will be in love with Sahaba, you will never go to any mistake they have done because they were humans. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in ayat many times, وَلَقَدْ عَفَىٰ عَنْكُمْ Whenever they did any mistake, Allah said, وَلَقَدْ عَفَىٰ عَنْكُمْ I have forgiven you. So respected brothers and sisters in Islam, anyhow, Ibn Abbas says, that be mindful of Allah, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَحْفَزْكَ He will protect you. And then, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ احفظني في الرخاء احفظك في الشدة In prosperity, when you are in good shape, be mindful of me, Allah says. Yes, I will remember you when you are in adversity. We do not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prosperity. And in adversity we are crying to Him. He says, I don't know you. Because you don't have any ambassadorial relation with me. Yes, when two countries, they do not have ambassadorial relation, they cannot register their protest to the other country that we don't have any relation. Know what I'm saying? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that in prosperity, you should establish good relation with me ambassadorial. So when you are in adversity, I will protect you. I will remember you. I will support you. I will help you. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so Imam Rahmatullahi Alayh, he told his son Hammad ibn Abi Hanifa that when you are in good shape, so keep your iman in between hope and fear. As much fear as you can, have it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can we measure the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You have any measurement? Yes, to measure. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهِ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have any limits, any bounds and boundaries in any aspect. So same is the case of His greatness. How great He is, there is no measurement. So how much fear you will have, no measurement. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اتَّقُ اللَّهِ حَقَّ تُقَادِهِ Some of us read said that this ayah is abrogated or repealed by another ayah, فَاتَّقُ اللَّهِ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ That here Allah says, Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as He is deserving. So how much the greatness of Allah is? No measurement. So fear without measurement. Yes, then Allah says that fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as much as you can. So to me, that is not abrogated. That is not abrogated because making a patch up between two ayat that is called i'mal in jurisprudence. And وَالْإِعْمَالُ أَوْلَى مِنَ الْإِهْمَالِ Yes, and to leave an eye of Holy Quran meaningless, not applicable, that is ihmal. And in jurisprudence there is a general rule, الْإِعْمَالُ أَوْلَى مِنَ الْإِهْمَالِ Never leave any eye of Holy Quran meaningless. Give a meaning to the eye of Holy Quran. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there are no limits as far as the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is concerned. But we are human, we have limits. We have hudud, we have boundaries, we have little bit power. So that's why Allah said, you should try to go to your utmost, but still, that will be up to the level of your power and your istita'ah. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Imam Abu Hanifa, to his son, once I was there in Iraq, yes, so our protocol officer, they were with us, Whenever somebody was mentioning the name of their ex-president who got hung, yes, So the people who were sitting there, they used to say, حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ وَرَعَاهُ. This is right, so they used to say, حَفِظَهُ اللَّهُ وَرَعَاهُ, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect him. So I asked that protocol officer, take حُبَّنْ لَهُ أَوْ خَوْفًا مِنَهُ. حُبَّنْ لَهُ. Brother Hisham, what I said? حُبَّنْ لَهُ أَوْ خَوْفًا مِنْهُ. You are making this dua for that guy every time. You have fear or you are in love with. So he laughed and he said, يَقُولُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ إِنَّ الْإِيمَانَ بَيْنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْرَجَاءِ. That we have both. We have fear and we have love. But anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I wrote this joke in one of my books as well. Yes. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, al-Iman bin al-Khawf wal-Raja, Imam said to his son, that keep your Iman in between hope and fear. Hope in the mercy and rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's my Lord, I'm a slave. Yes, but fear of Allah, He's my Lord, so I should not violate His boundaries. I should not transgress the boundaries. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala explained this hadith. And he said that on the day of judgment, if Allah will announce that all people will go to Jannah except one, so he said, I have that much fear that maybe that is me. That one exception is me. But he said, if on the other hand, Allah will announce all people will go to Jahannam except one, Sayyidina Umar says, I have that much trust in the mercy of Allah that maybe that is me. So, Imam Rahmatullahi Alayh, he said to his son, keep your Iman between Khawf and Raja. And he told him that when you are dying, at that time you may not be disappointed. Have a strong belief in Allah that I am going to my Lord and my King and for sure He will forgive me. I am going with all my sins, but He is waiting for me with all His mercies. This is the thing. That I am going towards Allah with what? What I am taking to Allah? Sins. Nothing else is there. But what He is having there waiting for me? Mercies and mercies and mercies. That is the nature of Allah. But there should be at the time of death. At lifetime, you have to do something. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam. Then number 20. And as you know, that 20 is an even number. So number 20, Imam Rahmatullahi Alayh, he told him that I have hundreds of thousands of hadiths. Altogether the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are 750,000. How many? 750,000. But this count means that sometimes one hadith is narrated through different chains. So if a hadith is narrated through four chains, that is counted four. Because the count according to muhaddiseen is like this. Even though the text is one and the same, the subject is one and the same, but hadith is narrated through different chains. So they are counting not the text, they are counting the chains, the sanad. So 750. This is a new point I have given you. As I told you that I will be giving you formulas, you will be in good shape inshallah. So anyhow, because when I am standing here, let me tell you one thing. For 2 years, when the problem was going on there, so I used to be intense, not because of the problem, because of that podium, when I was going to on Friday prayer. So before going to the podium, I was making a dua. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am human. Oh Allah, protect my tongue not to say anything based on prejudice I have for these people. Because prejudice, that's human nature. You will hate some people if they are torturing you mentally for no reason. Yes, or for the good you have done, but they are. My grandfather, he used to say that everything or every living entity which when it delivers, it delivers a baby of its own kind. Donkey will never deliver a cow. It will deliver what? Say, a donkey. A cow will never deliver a donkey. It will deliver? Yes. But he said that only one thing is that good will deliver bad every time. you will be doing good to some people and they will be. And he said that that is the case of human. In a hadith, Prophet ﷺ said that Allah said that what's wrong with the human? I am sending them good from my side and they are sending me sins and violation from their sides. What's wrong with them? So same is the case, this human nature, this human fault, this human shortcoming, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So anyhow, this podium is a responsible podium. And we claim that we are representing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So at that time, to tell you the truth, by God, I am standing here in the house of Allah, in Musalla, and delivering you the khutbah. At that time, the tense and the burden, I was feeling that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect my tongue. Not to say anything regarding this problem, and not to show any hatred in this khutbah of mine. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Imam Rahmatullahi Ali, he said that I have hundreds of thousands of hadith. Yes, the hadith which a student compiled from Imam Abu Hanifa, Rahmatullahi Ali. Now that is printed by the name of Jami'ul Masani, because every student, he has written a book of hadith from Imam Abu Hanifa, known by the name of Musnad Imam al-Azam. Musnad of Imam Azam, in a hadith which I have learned from Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayh. But now the ulama, they compiled it together and named it as Jami'ul Masani til Imam Azam. And the hadith there, these are 50,000 hadith narrated by Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayh, which is compiled by his the students. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Imam rahmatullahi alayh, he told, now some people they say, oh yes, the Hanafiya, they do not raise their hand when they are going to ruku or coming back from ruku. I say, you are doing. He says, yes, I am doing. I say, you are doing okay. Yes, we are not doing, we are also doing okay. Yes, they are not reciting Fatiha behind Imam. I say, brother, you do? He said, yes, I do. I say, you are okay. Yes, we are not reciting, we are also okay. Yes. Why? Because you know only one side of hadith, you do not know the other side of hadith. We don't have any objection to what you are doing, but we approve it. For example, if somebody is following Imam Shafi, rahmatullahi alayh, and he will tell me that I prayed but I did not recite Suratul Fatiha behind Imam, I will tell him, repeat your prayer. Because according to your Imam, your prayer is not done. Because Fatiha is Fariza according to Abu Hanifa. Otherwise, as a Hanafi, I should have told him that. Alhamdulillah, in one practice you became Hanafi, your prayer is done. No, I told him, just go back, repeat your prayer. Your prayer is not done according to your Imam, and you are bound to follow him in word and spirit. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, so today was writing here, the, what's the philosophy? The Imam Rahmatullahi Alayh, in this ibadah says one thing, in that ibadah he says other thing. So I found out that Imam Rahmatullah Ali, he is going deep in the very spirit and ruh of a specific ibadah. He does not go at riwayat, because riwayat are different. So he tries to find out the very spirit and the ruh and the nature of ibadah. So he says the nature of prayer is sukoon, seriousness. Sukoon, seriousness, aqliyat, yes, to be seen as a reasonable person, that you are a reasonable person, you are a very serious person, to have the mental tranquil and the mental peace. And the nature of Hajj is ishq, or love. So as you know, that if somebody falls in love with someone, so mostly his actions are looking like crazy, even though he's not crazy, but his actions are looking like crazy when he's talking. Looking like crazy. If you will talk to him against his beloved, then you will see the reaction. Yes, so he's not wrong, he's okay. But to the general public, he's looking like a wrong guy. Yet, oh, his mind is gone. His mind is not gone yet, gone to the proper place. So anyhow, so my dear respected brothers and sisters, when we talk to Najm, yes, so he's stuck there. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Imam said, rahmatullahi alayh, the spirit of prayer is aql, and the spirit of Hajj is love and ishq. He says, aql means to be with sukoon, with tranquil, with peace, less movements and harakat. But the case of Rishab is other way around, to have more and more harakat and movements and talking like blah, 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 blah. That's what the Ashiq and the lover does. So that's why Abu Hanifa rahmatullahi alayhi, when he is making a page up in ahadith in these two different ibadat, so he is looking for sukoon in prayer and for ashiq in hajj. So in prayer he says that its madar is sukoon, so less movements are very much appreciated. But less movements, not raising that many hands. Yes, that's his approach. And number two, in hajj, he says lot of movements. Because what is hajj? Movement. Walk around 7 times. Yes, reasonably. That's why some people ask me that why it is not allowed and permissible for non-Muslim to go to the haram or to Mecca, even though the difference of opinions there. Imam Abu Hanifa rahmatullah alayhi said they can go, but they cannot stay there. They can go, but they can not stay there. Imam Malik rahmatullah alayhi says they can go only for one day and night with the permission of the government concerned. But Ahmad bin Hanbal rahmatullah alayhi said yes, there should be a board. And as you know, that the Saudians, they are Hanabila. So there you will find the board for Muslims and for non-Muslims. Yes, the road separates this for non-Muslim, this for Muslim, because the hudud and the boundaries of haram starts a few mile matter. So anyhow, my dear respected, I told them that why he was a Muslim. He was asking me if he would have been a non-Muslim, my answer would have been in a different way. Because to non-Muslim, yes. So then I asked them that we are American citizens. They said, without restriction, we can go to the Oval Office. So they said, oh, that's protected area. And I say that where our weapons of mass destruction, can we fly over that zone? Their plan can go over that zone? They said, no. I said that every king, he has an own protected area. So Allah is the king of the entire world, he has his own protected area. What's your objection in this regard? Yes, but that was the case of a Muslim. So I told him that why? He said, why? Why? I asked him, have you ever gone for Umrah and Hajj? He said, yes. So I asked him that you walked around the house of Allah and then you walked in between Safa and Marwa? He said, of course. I said, does it make sense to you while you were walking around and while you were walking in between Safa and Marwa? He said, no, it does not make any sense to me, but that's an ibadah. I say, actually, the non-Muslim, they do not know the proper nature of our ibadah. So if they would have been there and watching us, so they were making, what's the purpose of this? Why am I walking around? And especially those who are living in America, for everything, they say, why? They say, we don't believe in mental blockades. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, let them not enter to that area, stop them. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Imam Rahmatullahi Alayh, he looked at Hajj, that Hajj means a lot of movement. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was asked by Sahaba Rizwanullahi Alayhim Ajma'in, Ikmal Hajj, what is Hajj? So now this is the detailed practice. I'm writing a book on, I completed Alhamdulillah, on Hajj in all four mazahir. Yeah, and that much big book. This is Hajj, according to Imam Abu Hanifa, according to Imam Malik, according to Imam Shafi, according to Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahumullah. Yes. So, Darussalam is a big company here, so they sent almost 12 questions. Yes. How many?
Yes.
12 questions that we want to paste it on our website, because we are the biggest ever company of Hajj from America, and we need the proper answer because we have some confusion there. Some people are Hanafi, some are Maliki, some are Shafi, some are Hanbali, and sometimes the disputes happen. So we should have some authentic answer that is up to you, you do it, and you do it. And then Fahim called me that I received from Darussalam 12 questions. So I was answering him that write it in the word I'm using. Yes, and then they take it. They take you or not? Okay, Alhamdulillah. So anyhow, my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the point was that Imam Rahmatullah Alayh says that in Hajj, lot of movement. Prophet ﷺ was asked, Mal Hajj? What is Hajj? Rasulullah ﷺ told them, Al Hajj wa Thajj. Al Hajj, what is Hajj? Little meaning is lot of noise. Yes, what? Lot of noise and was Thajj and plenty of blood. So what it means, they just make nice deer and kill each other to have the plenty of blood. Yeah? Say. No. Al-ajr, lot of nice, means don't be ashamed of when you are saying talbiyah with louder voice. Because that is sunnah. Talbiyah itself is wajib, but to say it with louder voice, that is sunnah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kullama habata aw sa'ada wadiyan. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going up, riding his she camel,